President Yoweri Museveni today officiated the reopening of iconic Makerere University's Ivory Tower after its full restoration after it was gutted by fire in September 2020. Makerere University Vice Chancellor Professor Barnabas Nawangwe, while speaking during the reopening ceremony held at the Freedom Square, thanked the government of Uganda for restoring and reconstructing the main building, Lumumba Hall, and the Makerere Law School.
When Professor Linette and I came to Cabinet to explain the cause of the fire, you guided the Cabinet to immediately approve the release of the 21 billion shillings that was required to reconstruct the building.
At the same event, President Museveni officiated the installation of Dr. Crispus Kiyonga as the university's new chancellor, who he congratulated upon the new role. Dr. Kiyonga succeeds Professor Ezra Suruma. The president also reiterated his long-standing call for improved science education in Uganda. He challenged Makerere and other institutions to enhance their teaching of natural sciences with a focus on value addition to raw materials.
Universities, including Makerere, are centers of knowledge. Now, one of the stimulus for the evolution of society is the advance in science and technology.
The First Lady and Minister of Education and Sports, Janet Museveni, also attended the ceremony. She reflected on the painful memory of the 2020 fire that destroyed the building, describing the restoration as a powerful symbol of resilience and renewal.
Makerere's main building is more than just infrastructure. It symbolizes the history and evolution of higher education in Uganda, and is a masterpiece of architecture.
Appearing before the Health Committee of Parliament, which is scrutinizing the surrogacy bill, the Uganda Human Rights Commission officials submitted that the age of surrogacy is moved to the age of 21 years or above. The commission argued that the youth at the age of 18 are vulnerable and are not in a position to make well-informed decisions about this process.
Majority of Ugandan youth at the age of 18, 19 and 20 also still in high school and have just joined tertiary institutions. So due to the importance of this process, the commission recommends that the age of surrogacy and gamete donation be moved to 21 years or above.
This reasoning was unanimously shared by the members of the Health Committee, who concurred that it is not proper for the youth of 18 years to indulge in surrogacy. The committee members also asserted that this bill should be controlled to avoid misuse by intended surrogate mothers.
But I would suggest that we add the age from 21 to 25.
And most of these deliveries of surrogate mothers, they are in most cases cesarean. And so you're exposing this young girl to a cesarean section, so I really agree with you.
The commission seeks to have amendments in the bill to rid it of the dangers of economic exploitation that could arise through unscrupulous people. The Human Assisted Reproductive Technology Bill 2023 was tabled before Parliament by the Tororo District Woman Member of Parliament, Sarah Opendi, and was aimed at assisting individuals facing fertility challenges or those with health challenges that affect their ability to have children.
Intending surrogate mothers should have previously given birth to at least one child to protect surrogate mothers from the risk of not having children of their own due to complications that may arise during the surrogacy process.
British Prime Minister Keir Starmer today met the European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen in Brussels during a joint press conference where both leaders condemned yesterday's attack by Iran on Israel and called for an immediate ceasefire across the Middle East. Iran's overnight attack on Israel could spiral into a far wider conflict, the EU has warned, as the two countries face off in an escalating exchange that threatens to engulf the entire Middle East.
I strongly condemn the ballistic missile attack launched yesterday by Iran against Israel The spiral of violence is threatening the lives of innocent civilians. It is also leading to a generalized conflict in the region, and this must be avoided by all costs. The European Union therefore continues to call for a ceasefire across the border with Lebanon, consistent with Resolution 1701, and the border in Gaza. And we will keep calling for the release of all hostages, as we have done for almost a year now.
We stand with Israel, recognizing her full right to security and to self-defense. We do need to pull back from the brink and to encourage all parties to find a way to de-escalate and for a political solution to the very many fronts of the crisis in the Middle East. And of course, foremost in our minds are the hostages.
The British Prime Minister Starmer today vowed to put ties with the EU on a positive footing as he kicked off a first visit to Brussels aimed at rebooting relations after the rancor of Brexit. Starmer also promised a reset with the European Union, but since taking power in July has given few details about how to improve on the painstakingly negotiated deals governing ties since the UK quit the bloc.